This is Good Morning Suncoast. We're here for you.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Rebecca Vargas.
And I'm Don Brennan, along with Steve Newman, who's in for John Scalzi. John is off today.
I think people
and
are
back tomorrow.
And he'll be back tomorrow. Mm-hmm. I think people are excited to be able to have some fresh eggs in their near future.
So.
For breakfast. I'm thinking about the chickens.
I know. It's very important. Obviously, it's
There's
a
difference.
Deal.
Have you tasted the difference between some of the grocery
I've never had
store?
A very fresh egg. I was never a big egg guy.
We need to get
up.
You a chicken in the backyard.
There you
yes.
go.
What comes first, the chicken or the egg?
I don't know. Oh, goodness.
We've got some great weather coming up today. A return to our storms that will cool things off later in the day. Yesterday, we didn't get them, and it was really warm and kind of muggy all night long. You see some storms off the east coast of Florida this morning, but most of the precipitation is confined down the Miami-Dade area and off the Atlantic coast, but the moisture will thicken up and those storms will develop over our area later on today. You can see that satellite view. It's just bubbling up here and there, and it will eventually reach us. 80 degrees, so it is warm outside, dew point 75, and the computer thinks we have a chance of rain increasing late this morning and during the afternoon. 60, 50, 40% chance as we move into the early afternoon hours, and temperatures warming up to the low 90s. Our complete forecast coming up in just a few minutes.
All right, thank you, Steve. Taking a look at Suncoast traffic right now at 602. Everything seems to be moving along without any problems in Manatee County. 75, 301, 41. The north-south main roads are going along nicely, and as are State Road 64 and 70. And as you move into Sarasota County, that too is flowing nicely without any accidents or delays. And just a reminder that the Osprey Avenue Bridge is now closed for the next year or so. So be aware of that, and please take alternate measures.
All right, well, tapping our news this morning, we have more details on an apparent double murder suicide in Manatee County.
All three victims were found inside a home on 38th Avenue West in Bradenton. It involved two adults and a child. ABC7's Rick Adams has the story.
New details continue to emerge in what deputies are treating as a double murder-suicide. The Manatee County Sheriff's Office have released the names of two of the three people whose bodies were found inside this home on 38th Avenue West in Bradenton. We're being told that 50-year-old Odalis Martinez Castiles and 2-year-old Zachiel Hernandez are the victims in this tragedy. A neighbor who did not want to show her face on camera lives a few homes away. She tells us she was napping when she was awakened by some loud bangs.
I heard gunshots. I'm not positive exactly how many I heard.
Farbo is a neighbor who lives down the street from where this happened. He and his neighbors are in shock.
And it's horrible, especially as like you have children around, kids, you know, playing around. It's like pretty horrible.
Deputies received an anonymous call from a man around 2 o'clock Monday afternoon saying there were two dead bodies in the front yard of the home. When deputies arrived, they didn't find any bodies outside but discovered three bodies inside the home. A motive has not been determined, but investigators are taking a hard look at some domestic issues.
We know that we've been here in 2009 for one domestic violence report, and in talking to some of the neighbors, there is sometimes a lot of arguing that goes on at this residence.
A woman who wanted to remain anonymous says she was friends with the female who was killed. She says they would sometimes confide in each other.
She would just say that he was a really jealous man, but that was pretty much all she would say.
The identity of the third person involved in this double murder-suicide has yet to be released, but the sheriff's office says he is a man in his 50s.
This has been an active crime scene for many hours now. Investigators are still trying to figure out exactly what transpired at the home back there. Reporting from Bradenton, I'm Rick Adams, ABC 7, your Suncoast News.
Meanwhile, exposure to a drain cleaner is suspected in the deaths of a mother and her adult son in Sarasota. This incident began as a hazmat situation on Margaret Street near Lyman 10th Streets. A relative found the two unconscious in the house yesterday morning. The mother was 78. Her son was 58. One died in the home while the other at the hospital. A medical examiner will determine their cause of death.
The Florida Highway Patrol is looking for information on a black Dodge pickup truck, which they believe may have caused a chain reaction crash that shut down parts of I-75 yesterday morning. The crash involved six vehicles, including two semi-trucks. Troopers say the pickup truck was heading south on the interstate when it cut off a semi. That semi went through the median, and several other vehicles also veered off the road. Around 40 gallons of diesel fuel spilled onto the roadway. Thankfully, no serious injuries were reported. The northbound lanes of I-75 were shut down for several hours following that accident.
It was a pretty bad one, too. I got caught up in some of that traffic and caused a lot of headaches for some. Hard Monday.
Yeah, some viewer pictures were sent to me right away. Like it was right around 11 o'clock yesterday morning, and it was pretty bad.
It was pretty bad. Well, when it comes to law enforcement, many agencies across the state require their officers to wear body vests at all times. But here on the Suncoast, a few of our agencies do not have those mandatory wear policies.
ABC7's Dwayne Lindo looks into the procedures that they do have.
With heightened violence against law enforcement of late, many agencies are looking to protect their officers.
And it makes sense that a lot of agencies would be reviewing their policies and discussing whether or not they want to move forward with a requirement to wear body armor.
Kevin Angel consults with law enforcement agencies around the country regarding safety. He cites Florida weather as a reason why some agencies are not making body armor mandatory.
As our temperature cracks 100 degrees, they're tough to wear, especially outside the vehicle doing anything like directing traffic in the middle of the daytime.
Some of the physiological effects of wearing body armor, you know, the heat, they weigh a lot.
And in the day-to-day operations of a Sarasota County Sheriff's deputy, they are not mandated to wear body armor. According to Captain John Walsh, the agency does provide vests to their officers, but they can wear it voluntarily.
I would like to think that most of our law enforcement personnel out on the street today are wearing it. It's become more of a cultural thing now. I don't leave my house without it.
And although this ballistic vest is not mandatory, it's required for each deputy to have one in their vehicle.
In their car, readily accessible, or if there's an event like a SWAT call out or a search warrant, you then must wear.
The Punta Gorda Police has a policy similar to the Sarasota Sheriff's. According to Lieutenant Katie Heck, they recently readdressed the issue and opted to keep it the same. Officers are encouraged to wear the armor at all times and must wear the suit in high-risk situations. And according to Walsh, the suits have a benefit outside of saving a life during a shooting.
If you get into some kind of an altercation during an arrest and you hit the ground, there are cases of, vests saving, cops' lives in car accidents.
Dwayne Lindo, ABC 7, your Suncoast News.
Thank you, Dwayne. And the city of Holmes Beach will host its National Night Out tonight. The event is an effort to bring the community together with law enforcement to improve relations and discuss concerns. There will also be kids' activities, music, free food, and bike giveaways. National Night Out will be held from 4 to 8 p.m. at Holmes Beach City Field. In Manatee County, the commissioners will meet today to discuss ways to fund public safety projects without increasing the property tax rate. As part of their budget meeting, the commission will consider a proposal to add 4 new 911 operators, 3 paramedics, and 13 new positions at the Manatee County Sheriff's Office. These additions come following a request by law enforcement and public safety officials. The positions will be funded through tax revenue from rising property values. Today's meeting begins at 9 a.m. in the Manatee County Administration Building. And in Palmetto, city commissioners have voted to keep the millage rate flat for the upcoming fiscal year. According to the Bradenton Herald, commissioners had considered increasing it to make up for a budget shortfall, but in a 3-2 vote, the millage rate will either go down or remain the same going forward. It will not be able to be increased, and the current rate is 5.9, similar to the other cities on the Suncoast. Palmetto will receive revenue from increasing property values as well.
And the Venice Community Center is going high-tech as part of a new Florida Power and Light project. 180 solar panels will be installed in the tops of the carport. The power generated will enter the city's power grid and be enough to power 10 homes for a year. That will save a total of about 60,000 pounds of coal.
Opportunity for them to showcase how you can take solar panels and use them for a secondary benefit of shaded parking.
FPNL signed a 30-year lease with the City of Venice. No tax dollars are involved. And speaking of FPNL, you can learn how to save on your power bill today. ABC 7 will be hosting a phone bank tonight during the evening news to answer your questions. FPNL experts will share some simple tips to save money. You can call in your questions anytime between 5 and 6:30 this evening. Just call the number on your screen, which is 941-552-3131. 27.
You can soon see more chickens in your neighborhood in Sarasota County. The county is considering a proposal that would allow backyard chickens in all residential single-family zoning districts, unless prohibited otherwise. The code would affect the number of chickens and coops allowed per property. The county is hosting two public workshops to get the public's input. The first one is today at the Sarasota County Administration Building at 6 p.m. The second one is tomorrow at the R.L. Anderson Administration Center in Venice. And you were so interested in this that you just had to find out how many eggs they laid per day.
About one a day once they get up and running.
So you could just, like, you know, save a few in the fridge, and then you'll have a lot.
Exactly. Now, reading, it's not only fundamental, but my mom always told me it's a beautiful thing, especially here in Sarasota.
Yeah, I'm sure you love this because I know how much you love
especially
to read in libraries.
Library.
Yes, Tech Insider has ranked the Gulfgate Library in Sarasota as the most beautiful library in the state of Florida. The ranking is based on libraries that have won awards from the American Institute of Architects and the America Library Association. The website says the library is recognized for its flexible meeting spaces and its inviting design.
Books.
Yes, the most important thing.
Exactly. You know, Selby Gardens is a little bit stinkier. It's always beautiful there, too, but it's a little bit stinkier because a second corpse plant, which is named Audrey, bloomed last night. Audrey's size has eclipsed that of her friend Seymour and stands nearly 6.5 feet tall. Selby officials say the plant's not-so-pleasant scent will be very strong for the next couple of days, so be aware of
she
that.
She said anything
rancid
you
smell.
Can do, I can do better. She
yes,
wanted to.
She did, and you thought that was me this morning, but it was the corpse plant that
maybe
smelled
it was
funny.
Smelled all the way to City Island there too, or Island Park.
No,
right across.
Yes, it's right across.
You'll get a chance to
breeze.
Go check it out tonight. They're going to keep, I think, the doors open a little bit later tonight, so you can just
so can
smell
view
it.
The corpse.
Yeah. Ooh. No,
they're viewing. They're having a viewing.
We are going to have afternoon thunderstorms that we can view later on today and bring us a nice, mild evening. Our complete forecast coming up in just a few minutes.
Also coming up, should convicted felons be allowed to vote? It's a debate raging in Tallahassee right now. We'll tell you more next.
Need new windows? Buy direct from the factory. New South Window is having a sale. The more you buy, the more you save. Buy four windows, save 25%. Buy six windows, save 30%. Buy eight or more windows and save 35%. How? Because New South owns the factory and you cut out the middleman. Award-winning, energy-efficient windows and doors installed with a lifetime warranty. New South Windows are made in Florida for Florida homes by Florida workers. Visit NewSouthWindow.com or call now.
Thank you, thank you. My fellow Americans, as your candidate for president, I will make bling affordable with Spectralite Diamonds.
Spectralite Diamonds are manufactured in laboratory conditions to equal the finest natural diamonds.
This political message was brought to you by Created Gems and the Bling Party.
Big bling for little change for you.
Getting older shouldn't mean giving up all the things she loves to do. It should just mean, well, finding new ways to do them. Right at Home's professional team thoughtfully selects caregivers to provide help with personal care, housekeeping, and of course, meal preparation.
Oh, that smells so good.
Oh, and it tastes good too.
We can provide the right care right at home.
We've been slow smoking over oak for more than 45 years. And while sticking to tried and true traditions is kind of our thing, it doesn't hurt to throw something new in the smoker every now and then. Come get some slow smoked chicken wings at Sonny's Barbecue. Order them as an appetizer or as part of a combo with pork, baby back ribs, or both, starting at $10.99. Sonny's Barbecue, local pitmasters since 68.
So many possibilities worth exploring. Minnesota Flooring.
Looking for carpet? Look no further. Minnesota Flooring has smart strand carpet as low as $1.79 per square foot. Installed, no add-ons or extras. Unbelievable? Minnesota Flooring can have in-stock carpet installed in your home in 48 hours for as low as $1.99 per square foot. Don't miss these prices. Visit Minnesota Flooring today.
There were highs.
Never seen anything like this.
And some lows.
Protests erupting outside.
There was a lot of anger. You had the WikiLeaks emails come out.
But when the Suncoast mattered most, no one covered it like ABC7.
Over the next 4 days, we will be covering our local Suncoast delegation.
There's a lot of excitement here.
We're standing right where those Florida delegates will sit.
I talked to some Suncoast delegates.
We were right in the thick of that.
This convention's done a lot of good for everybody.
ABC7 News. We're here for you, Suncoast. ABC7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you, weeknights at 5.
Well, even with our scattered thunderstorms and warm weather, this is why we live in the Suncoast. Look at this. Coquita Beach sunset yesterday sent in by Rob Hamilton. Thanks very much for that shot. And Cindy Desmond sent this beautiful sunset picture from the Pier at Sharkey's. Nice. And we'll probably have similar weather as we move right on into the weekend. Temperatures remained warm overnight in the absence of those sea breezes and the outflow boundaries from the interior storms. 80 at Tampa right now, 77 at Fort Myers and Naples, 76 in Tallahassee. And in our viewing area, a little warm right along the coast because of the waters keeping things warm, low 80s there, 79 at Northport, Arcadia 78. In the local viewing area, Anna Maria Island 83, Longboat 84, Siesta 82, and in the upper 70s in the interior parts. The same holds true further south, 80 at Rotunda right now, Minnesota 81 degrees with that beautiful sunrise just about to happen. Now there's some thunderstorms off the Atlantic coast and some tried to move over southern parts of the state, but they kind of died down. A few showers offshore moving away from us. We're going to be dry for a few hours, but things will change as the day goes on. That little green patch is a flood warning in effect for Myakka River, the Myakka River State Park. Here's a water vapor image showing you just little bubbles of moisture in the upper atmosphere, globs of it, and we will see an increase in moisture this afternoon and more widespread thunderstorms developing than we saw yesterday. Still dry in the northern part of the Atlantic, but there is the moisture from a disturbance that's come into the Caribbean and has the best chance in almost 2 years of becoming a tropical storm in the Caribbean. Off Africa, another wave has passed out there, but it's not going to make it. This one did. It moved into the Caribbean over the weekend, skirted Hispaniola, Puerto Rico, the Virgin Islands, and is now bringing gales and rain to the island of Jamaica. Invest 97L could be Tropical Storm Earl. If it does, it'll be the first tropical storm in the Caribbean since the end of the hurricane season 2 years ago. Developing 80% chance, and the computer models have day after day predicted it moving toward the Yucatan Peninsula. This is us. This is the storm. Really nothing to worry about, but it does look a little more impressive on satellite, but it still has no central circulation to become a named storm. High pressure controls the weather in the south. It's still cool with some locally heavy rain in the northeastern states, but that high pressure station from the Gulf into the Atlantic, the subtle changes in it provide our subtle changes in day-to-day rainfall patterns. And we see this afternoon a chance of them developing by late in the day and through the evening hours, some of the outflow boundaries cooling things off for us. Hopefully, at one point this week, that's going to happen in really big fashion. But you can see for the next couple of days, just scattered. If you're going out on the water, temperatures are going to be quite nice with the easterly winds in the morning becoming northeasterly in the afternoon at 10 knots. Seas 2 feet with a light chop. And 91, the beach temperature this afternoon. Great place to go to escape the heat. Get in the water, though. It's 89 in North Lido. Here's a 7-day outlook showing we will have a 50 to 60% chance of rain each day right on into next weekend with temperatures just above seasonal normal. It's your weather.
Thank you, Steve. As far as your traffic right now at 619, it looks like our roadways are pretty clear this morning. Bridges out of Palmetto are moving along well, so is the interstate in both directions. 41-301 all green into Sarasota. No slowdowns there to report. Just another reminder that that Osprey Bridge is closed for a year now. So be aware that between 41 Mound Street and Hillview, that is closed. You need to find a new route. As far as the interstate in 41, arteries out to 75, all are clear. And we're seeing the same story in Venice and Northport. Well, do you ever wonder who walked the Suncoast before we did and who really got the ball rolling in creating the wonderful communities that we live in today?
Did you ever wonder?
I did. There's a few people that we know, like the Ringling and brothers. And
even John Fogerty. Not the singer, though. ABC7's Linda Carson introduces us to some of the people in a place we call home.
In 1865, as brothers John and Bartholomew Fogerty, successful shipbuilders from Key West, sailed down the Gulf, they ran into a storm.
And they ran out of food, and they needed food. So they came up the Mantee River, and John, this is on a book called The Grover King, and John looked around, and being a boat builder, he saw all the live oak, the cypress and cedars that are still around here now, and thought it'd be a good place to settle and start building boats.
The next year, three Fogerty brothers came back and claimed the land under the Armed Occupation Act of 1842.
Which states if you clear and maintain 5 acres for 5 years, you get 165 acres. The three acreages combined was the basis of Fogertyville.
The oldest brother, John, started a boat building business.
He owned the store, he owned the shipyard, he owned the property, and he built homes and rented them out or sold them.
Business was booming for the Fogertys.
They were building boats and shipping all around the Caribbean up to the Atlantic coast, up into New England, all up into there, carrying produce, carrying goods, machinery, whatever they could.
This was the first church in Fogertyville.
This is called the St. Luke's Chapel. It was built in 1885. This corner, the original 20 foot of this corner, is it. This is the original dentil work and the columns and everything.
Fogertyville's second church, the Sacred Heart Catholic Church, also still stands. Both churches are now private homes. Bradentown, a small hamlet nearby, began to outgrow Fogertyville.
At that time, Fogertyville was dying out because they were shipbuilders. And with the railroad coming in and traffic easing up off the water, boats weren't so much in demand, and therefore they were kind of out of work.
Fogertyville is gone now, but Lewis Park is a reminder of its glory days.
Which was actually Toll Fogerty's homestead that his daughters neglected to pay taxes on. And so the city of Bradenton took it over during the Depression for back taxes.
Bob Pitt, also a shipbuilder, has lived in Fogertyville for 38 years. He says it is a great place to call home.
I love it. It's close to the water. We're at 14-foot elevation, so we're not really too concerned about a flood right here.
Fogertyville is gone now, but the legacy of the Fogerty brothers and the beautiful community they created are a proud part of Manatee County history. Linda Carson, ABC 7, your Suncoast News.
All right. Amazing. And so she always looks so nice. That's just amazing clothes she wears. Still ahead on Good Morning Suncoast.
There's growing concern of the spread of Zika virus as the number of cases spread by mosquitoes is increasing to 14 in Florida. We have the latest from Miami coming up.
My dad is my hero, and I wanted to give him a chance to live life and be happy. Granny Nannies has been a huge help. It has contributed to the health and happiness of my dad, for sure.
A helping hand and a gentle heart.
Today at 4 on Suncoast View.
I'm Stephanie Roberts. On Suncoast View, a Suncoast designer brings us grab-and-go clothes perfect for travel, plus sea salt, Venice Cabaret, and Michael's on East.
Today at 4 on Suncoast View.
U.S. Med has great news for anyone living with diabetes.
If you have Medicare, private insurance, or prescription drug coverage, U.S. Med will ship a new glucose meter right to your home.
And shipping is free.
My new meter uses only a speck of blood, so it's less painful than my previous meter.
If you have Medicare, private insurance, or prescription drug coverage, you're covered with U.S. Med. We're welcoming new patients, even if your current provider can't supply you anymore.
I don't even have to test on my fingers anymore. I can test on my hand or forearms, and it's more accurate than my old meter.
So call US Med today, and you'll have a choice of two great meters.
One that actually speaks your results, or a meter so small it fits on the bottle of strips.
Act now, and US Med will include a free prescription discount card. We'll also send you a free diabetes cookbook. This is your opportunity.
So call US Med today.
You'll be glad you did.
For your plumbing, electrical, or air conditioning, and services is qualified, and service calls are free. AndServices.com. ANDServices.com.
They're coming from Tampa, Fort Myers, even Orlando. They're coming from everywhere for the Sarasota Ford Promise. We promise we're more than a dealership. We're a destination with a movie theater, massage room, aquarium, cafe, and more. We promise to give you top dollar for your trade, even if you don't buy from us. And if you do, we promise you the best deal. Bring us any competitor's ad, and we'll beat it by at least $1,000. That's why they're coming from everywhere to Sarasota Ford, where 41 meets 301. SarasotaFord.com.
Today, everyone is looking for more fashionable choices in flooring than ever before. And G. Fried has responded with a huge selection of carpets, tile, wood, laminate, and vinyl. Installed by a highly skilled team, G. Fried has got everything you're looking for and more. The next time you think about quality flooring, think G. Fried Flooring America. G. Fried Flooring America. Our world is at your feet.
Granny Nannies, we've been making house calls for over 25 years. When you need home health care services, there really is no place like home.
Grandma!
A helping hand and a gentle heart.
Welcome back. It is 626. Pregnant women in a neighborhood near Miami are on high alert because of the Zika virus.
Lindsay Janis has the details in today's GMA First Look.
In this morning's GMA First Look, Dr. Richard Besser goes inside this Florida neighborhood, just 1 square mile north of downtown Miami, where 14 cases of Zika have been transmitted by mosquito.
There's still individuals that are at risk in that 1 mile square radius.
The virus most frightening for pregnant women.
How does it make you feel that Zika is so close to where you are?
It's scary. Because as a mother, you just want to protect your child.
Have you taken any steps around your home to cut down on mosquitoes?
Making sure none of my plants have water. That's just been mm-hmm. sitting there.
Yeah.
And I make sure to keep the door closed.
And coming up at 7 a.m., we'll go one-on-one with the director of the CDC. This is your GMA First Look. Lindsay Janis, ABC News, New York.
My trainer didn't believe me that Trop 50 could taste so good and still have 50% fewer calories.
Can I stop, Jane?
No.
Trop 50 tastes so good you won't believe it has 50% fewer calories.
Both these powders keep you nice and dry. This one's great for babies. This one's great for babes.
New Gold Bond Men's Body Powder. More than a baby powder, it controls odor, wetness, and smells irresistible.
Stay cool.
Good is in every blue diamond almond. Good is a catalyst. Good is contagious. And once it gets going, there's no stopping what you can do. Get your good going.
Blue Diamond Almonds, proud sponsor of the U.S. swim team.
Are you ready to take the Gel Envy Challenge? Revlon ColorStay Gel Envy with Diamond Top Coat. We challenged the leading competitor, and look how they cracked under pressure. Try it for yourself. Satisfaction guaranteed or your money back. Take the Revlon Gel Envy Challenge today.
Record-setting hot weather means your AC is working overtime to keep your home cool, which can lead to high bills. That's why we're bringing in the energy experts from Florida Power and Light Company. Watch ABC 7 News from 5 to 6:30 tonight to get your questions answered during the FPL Ask the Energy Expert phone bank. From smart technology to free online tools, learn how to save energy and money only on ABC 7.
Music on Main at Lakewood Ranch. If you haven't been, come on out and see what you've been missing. The first Friday of every month, you can enjoy a free concert, dancing, great food, and lots of fun for every family member, even the furry ones. Catch up with friends, enjoy free activities for the kids, or make it date night. Whatever your pleasure, there's something for everyone at Music on Main, the first Friday of every month at Lakewood Ranch. Brought to you by these sponsors and ABC 7.
There were highs.
Never seen anything like this.
And some lows.
Protests erupting outside.
There was a lot of anger. You had the WikiLeaks emails come out.
But when the Suncoast mattered most, no one covered it like ABC 7.
Over the next 4 days, we will be covering our local Suncoast delegation.
There's a lot of excitement here.
We're standing right where those Florida delegates will sit.
I talked to some Suncoast delegates.
We were right in the thick of that.
This convention's done a lot of good for everybody.
ABC 7 News.
We're here for you, Suncoast. ABC 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you, weeknights at 5.
At Sunset Subaru in Sarasota, it's all about getting more for your money. More years, more miles, more 2016 IIHS Top Safety Pick Plus winners than any other brand. Stop by to see our new state-of-the-art showroom today, and you can lease the most award-winning small SUV on the planet, a new 2016 Subaru Forester, for just $229 a month, complimentary maintenance included, at Sunset Subaru in Sarasota. Get more for your money. Go to Sunset Subaru in Sarasota.
Is your mop a dirty, disgusting mess? You need the Hurricane 360 Spin Mop System, the only mop and bucket that spins the dirt away. A system that cleans practically anything and everything with super absorbent microfiber. Dip it in the washer side and the mess releases into the bucket. Then place it in the dryer side and push on the pedal. You get a clean mop head that's practically dry and ready for more. And your hands will never again touch a dirty, disgusting mop. The heads are washable and reusable. Get the Hurricane 360 Spin Mop System for just two payments of $19.99. You'll also get a Sticky Buddy, the reusable sticky roller that picks up pet hair and lint and washes clean in seconds. You can take advantage of our 2-for-1 pick it up special and get a second spin mop set. Just pay additional shipping and fee. And we'll upgrade you to free priority handling. So don't wait. Order now.
Call 1-800-394-1524 to get your Hurricane Spin Mop double offer. So hurry and call 1-800-394-1524. Call now.
Coming up on Good Morning Suncoast, controversy over the death penalty could change the outcome of the trial for Dylann Roof. We'll have those details.
Plus, what Donald Trump has to say about the election following the release of the latest polls.
And Longboat Key residents set to decide on whether or not to bring more tourists to the area.
Live from the ABC 7 studios, this is Good Morning Suncoast. We're here for you.
Welcome back. I'm Rebecca Varkas.
And I'm Don Brennan, along with Steve Newman, who's in for John Scalzi today. Mm-hmm. And it, yesterday was really high. I know it wasn't 116 that it was out in Phoenix.
No.
But
with our humidity, it sure feels like it.
Yes.
Yeah, it felt like 105 here. It certainly did. And that was a dry day, and we didn't get the afternoon storms to cool us off for the evening, but that probably will happen today. We can see on our radar that there are some scattered showers out there that should increase as the day goes on. It is way early in the day to really be pinpointing exactly where all this is going to happen, but you can see them off the Atlantic coast. And on satellite, you can see scattered clouds here and there that will increase as our moisture increases during the afternoon. Currently at the airport, it is 80 degrees, a very warm night, the dew point 75, muggy, calm winds, nothing to cool you off, but with a dew point of 75, it's hard for even a breeze to cool you off. Look at the chance of rain go up to 30-40% by noon and then really spike about 2, 3, 4 this afternoon and maybe even another spike after sunset tonight. We'll keep our fingers crossed on that.
All right, thank you, Steve. Taking a look at Suncoast roadways, we do have our first accident in the morning. We'll tell you about that in a second, but Manatee County looking good. You do see volume picking up there on 301 and 41 heading, 301 heading southbound towards State Road 70 and 301 heading northbound towards State Road 64. In Sarasota County, don't forget the Osprey Avenue Bridge closed for the foreseeable future, at least a year. So be aware of that. Getting to Hillview from 41, you'll have to go or take 41. No cut through. There is an accident in South Sarasota County down there at I-75 northbound, a vehicle fire actually at Toledo Blade Boulevard. That's exit 179. So be aware of that there. You see it. I-75 northbound, the car fire.
Well, attorneys representing the Charleston shooter, Dylann Roof, are now arguing that the death penalty is unconstitutional and should not be used against him.
Federal prosecutors are intending to seek the death penalty in the case. Roof's lawyers filed a motion yesterday claiming the death penalty and federal death penalty are unconstitutional. If a judge agrees and declares it unconstitutional, Roof could then enter a guilty plea and be sentenced to life in prison without the possibility of parole. Roof is also facing a death penalty trial in state court next year. He's accused of shooting and killing 9 people at the Emmanuel AME Church in North Charleston. South Carolina last year. And turning to the campaign trail, Donald Trump trying to move past his public spat with the Khan family.
He's not apologizing for his comments, instead now turning his focus back to the fall election. ABC's Maggie Rooley has the latest on the race for 2016.
Within hours of new polls showing Hillary Clinton with a solid lead in the race for the White House, Donald Trump declares this.
I'm afraid the election's going to be rigged, I have to be honest.
He calls on all Republicans to be careful come Election Day during an interview on Fox News.
And I hope the Republicans are watching closely or it's going to be taken away from us.
While Trump is focusing on a rigged election, many veterans groups and even his own party continue to condemn his comments. Republican Senator and war hero John McCain is leading the charge, saying in a blistering statement, while our party has bestowed upon him the nomination, it is not accompanied by unfettered license to defame those who are the best among us. GOP vice presidential nominee Mike Pence, out on the campaign trail, was forced to defend Trump's remarks when a military mother asked about the controversy. The pro-Trump crowd began booing. Pence went on to say that he and Trump support military families.
Having spent time with our nominee, I have never been around someone more devoted to the armed forces of this country.
In Virginia, Clinton's vice presidential nominee Tim Kaine took on Trump's controversial Muslim ban.
You know, if it's Muslims this week, it could be Mormons next week, or it could be Baptists the week after that. So this is a race that is just absolutely incredible.
Another member of Team Clinton taking aim at Donald Trump, billionaire Warren Buffett. He's challenging Trump to release his taxes before Election Day. Maggie Rooley, ABC News, Washington.
Advocates across Florida are working to restore the voting rights of felons. Dozens of supporters were at the Florida Capitol yesterday calling for lawmakers to automatically restore the voting rights of people who have been convicted of felonies and have served their sentences. Florida is one of only a handful of states where this does not happen. The current clemency rule states that those convicted must wait at least 5 years after leaving prison before their voting rights can possibly be restored, and even then, restoration is not guaranteed. Some advocates feel the current law is a form of minority voter suppression.
In many cases, the people been out 20 years, working jobs, not getting in additional trouble, but yet they still cannot vote. Unacceptable.
I have not been in trouble. I've been in close to 30 years ago. So I am a very product of, if you restore voting rights, if you give people their rights back, hey, they will stay out of trouble.
If they want to vote, primary elections is on August 30th, if they're able to vote.
500,000 voters between Sarasota and Manatee counties will cast their votes in the primary election later this month. Early estimates show nearly 300,000 voters have registered to vote in Sarasota County, while 220,000 registered in Manatee County. Voters who registered over the last couple of days or through the mail still have not been counted. So far, the number of voters has increased 6% from 2014. And 9% from 2012. Across the two counties, 224,000 people registered as a Republican, 159,000 as a Democrat, and 132,000 registered as independent. Meanwhile, USF Sarasota Manatee will host candidate forums today for those running for Florida's House of Representatives and the 16th Congressional District. The first forum will feature candidates running for State House District 70, while the second forum will feature Democrats running for the 16th Congressional District. The forums will be held today from 4 to 6 in the evening at the Selby Auditorium on campus. It is free and open to the public. Longboat Key voters will decide whether to place a new boutique hotel on the north end. On the ballot, the town hall will be asking voters if they want to rezone property on the north end of the key to make way for the 120-room hotel. The company's Florida's Development and Prime Group want to build the hotel along North Palm Avenue. Florida's will need to rezone that property from commercial to tourism zoning. And as it stands right now, the new lodging would be called Hotel Sarasota. Well, for the final time, President Obama made his last major address as commander-in-chief to veterans yesterday. The president spoke at the annual convention of the Disabled American Vets in Atlanta. During his speech, the president says the Department of Veterans Affairs has made some serious progress. He says it's hired more doctors and clinicians since the scandal over the long wait times for services. The president also touched on how veterans can inspire us.
And I have seen time and time and time again the strength of our veterans, the unbreakable will of our disabled vets. You teach us, better than anybody, that we may take a hit sometimes. We may get knocked down, but we get back up. We carry on. And when we take care of each other and uphold that sacred covenant, there's nothing we cannot do.
The president says the U.S. must do everything it can to honor families whose relatives have died serving in the military.
Tampa Bay Rays traded pitcher Matt Moore to the Giants, Brandon Guyer to the Indians, and Steve Pierce back to the Orioles yesterday. The only widely known name that they received in return besides prospects was the Giants third baseman Matt Duffy, and Duffy was not really a name the Rays wanted to hear last night. Royals left-hander Danny Duffy pitched seven innings of a no-hitter before a leadoff single by Desmond Jennings in the eighth broke up that no-hitter, but he was on fire, looking good, and he shut the Rays down like they had no-hitters, and they ended up winning 3-0, the Royals did. The Rays and the Royals back at it again tonight. And well, this looks like a normal, nice play by a ball girl, and you see a line drive down left field line at Dodger Stadium. She makes the catch, nice play, right? And then flips the ball into the stands. But as you see more closely, that gentleman that she handed the ball to was on his phone, and the line drive was 108 miles an hour, and she snatched it out of the air nonchalantly right in front of his face. He wasn't paying attention, so he might have ended up in the emergency room. Instead, he gets a nice little souvenir and a Dodger win, and he gets me on TV all over the country and all over the internet because that is trending for sure. But he was watching his phone, not paying attention to the game.
That's happened?
That's a hazard.
Pretty impressed by the girl, though.
That was a beautiful play. And even
great.
Vin Scully.
She said, and it looked effortless to her. She just laughing.
She did.
I saved your life. No big deal. Saved your face. And yesterday was the start of football, high school football season practice.
Indeed. Already?
Yeah. Already here. Can you believe it? Yeah, are you excited?
I'm excited.
I like football Friday night.
Go Sailors.
No, go Braden River Pirates. No, we like the Sailors too. We love all of our teams.
Oh, you can't get back from that.
I can't get back from that. We have to represent the whole Suncoast.
No,
well, if you graduate from a school, you can root for them. Come on.
Did you graduate from Sarasota High School?
Yes, class of, you know.
Oh, that's awesome.
So let's take a look at the weather in a couple of minutes. We've got some scattered thunderstorms coming our way. And as we look over Sarasota Bay, you can see a lot of blue and a few fluffy clouds. The complete forecast coming up.
Tonight on ABC 7 News at 7.
We have to continue looking at the projects that are underway that have been approved, get those things funded, stop pointing fingers, and do more.
Algae becomes political. Waters in South Florida continue to be plagued. Find out what's being done locally to keep waters here in the Sun Coast clean. I'm Ray Collins. That story plus our roundtable discussion.
Tonight on ABC 7 News at 7, your Sun Coast News. We're here for you.
Hi, I'm Joan London, and if you're worried about your parent or a loved one living alone like I was, and you want reliable senior care information, then call A Place for Mom, the nation's largest senior living referral service. You'll get free information on assisted living, Alzheimer's care, nursing homes, even important financial information.
They had obviously researched every place, not just given me names. Really? They found me a place for what she could afford, and it was magnificent.
We're now very confident that she's safe, and they just helped every step of the way, and I can't thank them enough.
So if you're struggling to find reliable senior living information, call A Place for Mom. This is a free service, and you can trust them to help you.
Call right now to get your free Senior Care Compass ebook. Find out about the 5 best kept secrets on financing senior care and assisted living.
Call now, 800-290-0352. 800-290-0352.
Today, everyone is looking for carpeting that lasts longer. G. Freed has you covered with Karastan. With a legacy of quality and integrity, we provide you with a huge selection of Karastan carpets with exclusive lifetime limited warranties. All installed by our highly skilled, highly knowledgeable team. Come ask us why Karastan is the best and most durable. G. Freed Flooring America. Our world is at your feet.
For your plumbing, electrical, or air conditioning, and services is qualified, and service calls are free, and
andservices.com.
andservices.com.
Welcome back, two of my favorite guests, Cash 3 and Play 4.
Surprise! We're Pick 3 and Pick 4 now!
Whoa!
But we still play exactly the same. We just got a fresh new look.
Speaking of surprises, I have one for you. Say hello to Pick 2 and Pick 5!
Introducing the complete Pick family of games.
Yeah. We're family now!
The new Pick 2 and Pick 5 have joined Pick 3 and Pick 4 to give you more choices in your daily gameplay. The Florida Lottery. Just imagine.
We had a great sunset last night, especially at Coquina Beach. Look at that. How romantic, how beautiful. Why we love living on the Suncoast. Thanks, Rob Hamilton, for sending that pic in. And thanks to Sydney Desmond for sending this picture of sunset at Sharkey's. Also, an extraordinarily beautiful sight. Temperatures across the state at this hour. They stayed warm overnight because we didn't have the big, huge thunderstorms rumbling from top to bottom as we did over the weekend. 80 at Tampa, 71 at Gainesville, 81 at Miami at the current hour. And across our viewing area, temperatures range from the low 80s right along the coast to 77 at Arcadia, Lake Placid, 76. Right out on the Keys, look at this, 83 at Anna Maria, 84 Longboat, 82 Siesta. So those warm Gulf waters clearly are keeping things warm and humid out there right along the Gulf Coast, but it's going to be a great place to go later on today if you want to escape the heat. 81 at Minnesota, warm Mineral Springs, 79, and Port Charlotte, 78 at this hour. Now we'll be taking a look at the radar across the state. Most of the storms are right now out in the Atlantic. A couple tried to form over Miami-Dade and move over the Everglades, but they have dissipated. And there's one little area of thunderstorms that have been well offshore of the Suncoast overnight. They are moving away. That is a flood warning for the Myakka River at Myakka River State Park because of the heavy rains over the weekend. It'll slowly subside. Now, the moisture is beginning to thicken up, as we can see in this water vapor image, and we'll probably see an increase in afternoon showers and thunderstorms as a result, and as a result of the sea breeze kicking in, too, and colliding with the prevailing southeasterly wind coming in. Now, a lot of dry air over the North Atlantic keeping things quiet, but look at this. We do have a tropical feature that is trying as hard as it can to become a tropical storm. Look at it in a minute, but off Africa, we have a couple of waves that are not going to amount to anything, but this one could. It could become Tropical Storm Earl. The National Hurricane Center gives it an 80% chance of developing in the next 2 days, right now bringing rain to Jamaica. And the computer models, day after day since Saturday, have predicted it will move toward the Yucatan Peninsula. It's going to encounter wind shear, though, out here, so if it doesn't make it to tropical storm force here, it probably won't. And if it does become a tropical storm, it'll be the first one since the end of the hurricane season 2 years ago. Looks kind of impressive on satellite, but we'll wait and see if it becomes anything. High pressure is controlling our weather across Florida, as it does generally during the summer, controlling the wind flow and the subtleties of our afternoon showers and thunderstorms. And our RPM computer forecast shows that we'll have scattered showers returning this afternoon and tonight, becoming more widespread as we move through the week. Temperatures hopefully will cool off in the evening once we get these storms. It's so chaotic, it's hard to pinpoint exactly when it would happen, but you get a general idea. Winds from the east this morning, northeast in the afternoon, seas 2 feet, Bay and inland waters a light chop, and the Gulf temperature 89. The air temperature at the beach today, 91. Hit the beach. I'd love to. Here's a 7-day outlook, and it shows a 50 to 60% chance of precipitation for the rest of the week. Temperature is a couple 3 degrees above seasonal normal. That's your weather.
Thank you, Steve. Taking a look at traffic right now at 649. It looks like we're just starting to see some cars getting on the road there in Palmetto heading into Bradenton, but nothing to slow you down just yet. 41, 301 and the interstate are all clear at this point in the morning. Looks like we're just seeing that warning about the Osprey Bridge being closed, so you must take 41 Hillview and Mound. It is closed in that area. Looks like the arteries out to 75 are still clear at this point. No major congestion just yet. And as far as South County, still just telling you a little bit about an accident happening there on I-75 at Toledo Blade Boulevard there. The exit is 179 and it's in the northbound lanes. Not causing slowdowns just yet, but be aware of that if you're heading from South County up into Sarasota at this point in the morning.
Now, when there's an accident or traffic, you're sitting, right? Mm-hmm. Millions of us sit hours and days and years of our lives, whether it's at work, in the car, watching TV, whatever it is. And past studies have shown that long periods of sitting and TV viewing are linked to an increased risk of early death and chronic diseases like diabetes and cancer.
There might be some good news. We might be able to reverse this. New research shows it doesn't take much to cancel out the risk. Researchers analyzed data from 16 studies, including more than a million people. They found that getting as little as just 1 hour of physical activity a day could eliminate the increased risk of premature death. The best results came with 60 to 75 minutes of moderate intensity physical activity, like a jog. Well, James Patterson will soon be writing for TV. The author is teaming up with the Investigation Discovery Channel for a 6-part scripted series. This series will focus on true crime stories written by Patterson. He will also serve as executive producer on the show. The stories featured in the show will also be released as 150-page books. The series will premiere next year.
Channing Tatum is going under the sea. The actor is set to star in a remake of Splash, the 1984 romantic comedy about a man who falls in love with a mermaid. That was Tom Hanks and Daryl Hannah. There is a catch, though. Tatum will play Daryl Hannah's former role as the mermaid, or merman. Jillian Bell star alongside Tatum as the love-struck human. A merman.
A merman.
Women just
looked at all. I think a lot of people are going to enjoy this movie.
A lot of people are going to enjoy this movie. Look at you. You're already enjoying it.
It's going to be a good one. What? No. It's going to be a good one. I think Channing Tatum's a really good actor. Still ahead on Good Morning Suncoast.
Yes. Magic Mike. Well, a garbage truck turned into a taxi service in New Mexico. It was a bear of a ride. We'll tell you all about it coming up.
Music on Main at Lakewood Ranch. If you haven't been, come on out and see what you've been missing. The first Friday of every month, you can enjoy a free concert, dancing, great food, and lots of fun for every family member, even the furry ones. Catch up with friends, enjoy free activities for the kids, or make it date night. Whatever your pleasure, there's something for everyone at Music on Main, the first Friday of every month at Lakewood Ranch. Brought to you by these sponsors at ABC7.
Hurricane season is here. Are you prepared? ABC7 has the information you need. Access our special Surviving a Hurricane now. Learn how to prepare a readiness plan and survival kit. Know your evacuation route. Be prepared, Suncoast, when severe weather threatens. Access our special on our ABC7 app and all our live streaming platforms.
Apple TV, Amazon Fire TV, and Roku. ABC7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
We are delighted to have Dr. Kaminsky join our team at the Totola Cancer Center.
I'm a radiation oncologist. I was at the National Institutes of Health, most recently at the Medical College of Georgia, specialized in central nervous system cancers, prostate cancers, and other types. At the Totola Cancer Center, we have a level of technology that is second to none.
He has a great wealth of knowledge and shares the same passion that we have for patient care.
My family and I are happy to be here in Sarasota and excited to treat our patients here at the Totola Cancer Center.
Attention, this is an important message for anyone who had an IVC filter placed to prevent blood clots from traveling to their heart or lungs. Did your IVC filter move, break, or cause organ damage? The FDA warns that IVC filters may cause serious complications, such as heart or lung damage, internal bleeding, even death. If you or a loved one suffered serious complications, call IVC Filter Helpline now. You may be entitled to compensation. IVC filters are designed to prevent blood clots. If your IVC filter moved or broke, and you suffered heart or lung damage, internal bleeding, or if a loved one died as a result, call IVC Filter Helpline today. Our network of experienced attorneys is ready to fight for you. You'll pay nothing unless there's a recovery in your favor. Call today for a free confidential consultation. Don't fight this alone. Call IVC Filter Helpline now.
Please call 800-897-6764. That is 800-897-6764.
They say good things come to those that wait. Well, you've waited long enough. You deserve to feel fabulous in your fashionable new Fiat 500X from Alfa Romeo Fiat in Sarasota. Boldly innovative, seductively stylish. Fiat gives you everything you'd expect from a capable utility vehicle, like a spacious interior and advanced safety systems, designed and built like a sexy little sportster. Don't wait any longer. You deserve to feel fabulous. Get a new Fiat at Alfa Romeo Fiat of Sarasota.
The kitchen is where life happens. Minnesota Flooring now offers a wide variety of beautiful quality craft-made cabinetry to make sure the heart of your home reflects your style. Visit us today.
It is 6:55, and as far as your roads right now, you're seeing a clear interstate as well as the Palmetto Bridges. 41 and 301 are moving along nicely as well. It just looks like the Ringling Bridge is seeing some traffic as you come on into downtown Sarasota. We're seeing some slowdowns there at Stickney Point, just around 41, but nothing to slow you down too much this morning. And that accident still on I-75 northbound in South County. That's at exit 179, which is Toledo Blade Boulevard. No slowdowns due to that accident just yet.
And we have some scattered showers over South Florida. And since our wind flow is from the southeast, I'm showing you this because any storms that we get will be a result of that southeasterly flow and our sea breeze front colliding with it later today.
All right, check this out. Why settle for a trash can when you could have the whole garbage truck, right? Well, one bear in New Mexico went straight to the source to find his food. You see him riding atop the garbage truck there in Los Alamos. The truck drove by a fire station, so the firefighters caught the scene on camera. After driving around a little bit, the truck driver, in a very intelligent move, decided to back up to a tree for the bear to climb off. And then the truck drove away with lunch.
With lunch? More hey, than he was a very smart bear.
Smarter than your average bear.
Yeah. Smart garbage truck driver, too.
Exactly.
Pull him up to something that he likes to climb. There you go. All right, stick around. Good Morning America's next. Have a good morning.